Hey, 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 it is Paul Jang, and today we're going to be talking about how my wife was able to quit her job by investing in land. So there's three secrets to quit your job. The first secret is that what we did with land investing is that we focused on owner finance deals. And what we tried doing was that we got our money back in the down payment. So what that means is if we bought a property that was worth $10,000, we bought it for, you know, $2,000 or $2,500. Generally, we try to stay around the 25 cents per dollar. In certain markets, it might have to be a little bit more. In other markets, it could be a little bit less. But generally, that's what we try to shoot for. And what we did was when we bought the property, we sold the property with owner financing and asked for a down payment on what we purchased it for. So if we paid $2,500 for it, then we asked $2,500 for the down payment. And once we received the down payment, like, hey, you know, we'd sell it to you for, you know, $9,000 or $8,000, you know, kind of give them a discount, but, you know, charge interest with it, and we'd get principal and interest for the next, you know, 5-6 years. And when we did this, is we kind of focused on similar property in the beginning, but over time we started, you know, getting a variety of different property as well. What we kind of like averaged out to was that each parcel of land gave us about $200 per month. You know, like just doing a couple of these, it got us to a point that my wife was able to quit her job and stay with our son. And we just kind of reinvest our money into more and more term deals. Now, secret number two is you need to get a large variety of different land. So what I mean is if you stick with a certain county, you know, you go after the 1 acre, you know, the quarter acre, but you also kind of expand yourself to the 5 acres and 10 acres and 20 acres. By having a variety of land, it gives us different options. If we had a certain buyer and they couldn't, you know, afford a bigger lot, you know, we could kind of guide them to the smaller lot. But if they had, you know, some other needs, like, you know, that they want to do it and our smaller lot's going to fit into it, then, you know, we would offer a bigger lot that might, I guess, like handle their needs, right? Like take care of their needs. And so what we did was we started focusing on a variety of property to sell ultimately, right? And as you get more and more pieces of land, you'll be able to kind of guide them in you know, different parts of your inventory. So here's the secret, right? If you have more inventory, it leads to more sales, right? And so how do you like get these like deals and stuff? Generally, we sent mailers for them, right? But when we send out these mailers, we continuously do it, so we get more and more deals. That means more and more inventory, right? And because we're doing secret number one with focusing on the owner finance deals, we get our money right back, right? Like, I mean, cash deals are good too. So like, you know, I don't discount those, but one or the other, in terms of owner financing, I'm saying that because that's what allowed my wife to quit. It's good to get like a check for $20,000, but after a little bit, that money is gone and our cash flow situation needs to be taken care of. So it's really the passive income, every month something coming in, that kind of really made the difference in terms of her being able to just leave her job and for us to feel secure enough that like we'll be okay. Okay, so secret number three, get funding for your deals, right? So it's good if you have a nice nest egg and you have a lot of cash on hand, but if you know, if that's not you, and that wasn't the case for us, what we did was whatever amount of money that we put in, we were careful to kind of preserve that capital. So we would do the cash deals whenever we could, but also start doing the owner finance deals and working in a way that we got our money back, or at least most of it back in our down payment. The second thing that we did was that we built a line of credit, right, with our credit union. So you might be able to find it with your local bank if you have a relationship with them, but I found that credit unions are a really good way to get a line of credit. And what a line of credit is it acts like a credit card. They give you a limit on how much you could borrow from them. And at the end of the month, you kind of have to like start paying them back, right? But what's cool with lines of credit compared to credit cards is with a credit card, you can only do it with, you know, like a swipe. You go to, you know, Walmart or Target or wherever, and you buy your you know, products or groceries or whatever, and you know, swipe, and you have to pay them back. A line of credit, what it does for you is it's the same concept, except there's a middle stage where they give you cash instead of having to swipe. So what we did was that with our line of credit, whenever we would have a deal of some sort and we didn't have the cash on hand because it was locked in with other properties, we borrow from our line of credit, you know, $2,000 or $5,000 or $15,000, $20,000, and then we use that money to buy our parcels of land. We would basically wire the funds over to the title company if it was a larger deal, or we'd send a check over to the person that we're buying it from if we're doing a self-closing. And what that did was it freed up our ability to get a larger inventory. Right now, if you don't mind asking your friends and family whenever a deal comes, like, you can go ahead and use them as a resource if you have those relationships. But if you don't have that, like, start with your own capital and get a line of credit. And that'll kind of open your way into getting into the business more. Another thing you can do, you can also partner with private lenders. So this could be your friend or family member, but it's also common for people to connect with other land investors like me. And, you know, when you have a deal in place, we can split the profits 50-50 and I'll fund it for you. So, money's not really, you know, something that should prevent you from moving forward in the land flipping, land investing niche, right? If you're able to find one of these ways, you have access to capital that you might not have realized you had access to. And by doing it that way, you could, you know, speed along and just kind of have a little bit more oomph into getting more and more deals. So that's it. That's how we were able to get my wife to quit her job and stay with our son. And the three secrets that kind of helped us do that, right? We just kind of did one deal at a time, right? And just kept it moving, and it just kind of snowballed into a sizable amount that my wife was able to quit her job. Okay, so that's it, y'all. If you can, subscribe and like this video. It helps with the YouTube algorithm. And put in the comments below any questions you might have. And if you have any ideas for future videos, I'd like to hear about them. Take care. Have a good one.